On June 25th, 2015, a video would be uploaded to YouTube by the channel Obscure Horror Corner. In the video that followed, viewers would go on to witness what appeared to be a very basic horror game, in which the player is subject to never-ending hallways, random sounds that made little sense, and disturbing images. By the end of the video, people would be left dumbfounded at what the hell they had just witnessed. Looking at the title and seeing Sad Satan, Deep Web Horror Game Part 1, we quickly are able to piece together that this was a series, just as most Let's Play channels have. Over the course of the next week, the channel would go on to upload 4 more videos, making 5 in total, all of which were made of the same random, creepy, and confusing elements they saw in the first video. After the 5th video, the channel would go silent, and remains in this state to this day, as of the date of this upload. What would follow would be one of the most cryptic and bizarre stories the internet had ever seen, filled with so many puzzle pieces that it became almost impossible to distinguish what was fact and what was just a plausible theory. This is the story of Sad Satan and how a game was born into obscurity, lived in the unknown, and faded into anonymity. This needs to be said right from the start, that this is not going to be a deep dive into what the game contains or a breakdown of each video that Obscure Horror Corner uploaded. Also, going forward, I am going to refer to Obscure Horror Corner as OHC. As I said previously, most of the videos are the same, just very minor differences. This video is aimed towards uncovering the story behind Sad Satan and how it quickly became a rabbit hole for so many people, myself included, as it strongly is believed to deal with real-world crimes and people. But before I get ahead of myself, let's go back to 2015. More specifically, 2015 on YouTube. The rise of Let's Play channels were in full swing, and many of the most popular creators on the site were gamers. Even channels that didn't focus on video games were seemingly jumping onto the bandwagon, with secondary channels dedicated to popular games at the time. And at the time, the most popular game genre was horror. Thanks to the likes of people like PewDiePie and Markiplier, the horror scene was thriving, and indie horror games were headlining many people's recommended videos. It's easy to see why, honestly. It's why we all like scary movies so much. The rush and thrill of feeling fear, but from the comfort of your own home, where you know that you are in no danger. So when OHC uploaded their Sad Satan series, nobody thought much of it at first. Yeah, it looked horrible, and the sound seemed very cheesy, but overall, it looked like a standard, quickly made horror game that at the time were flooding the Steam marketplace in hopes of being featured on a huge channel. And that's the thing about this game. Nothing was crazy about it. I have, and I'm sure most others have seen scarier games. It being titled as the scariest game of all time is, in my opinion, ridiculous, simply because a game seemingly has no point to it and has some random creepy sounds. Is it creepy? Sure. Is it something that will scar you for life? I doubt it. And this is why the story stood out to me, because I don't think the horror aspect of it was the intended direction of the developer. And here is where I would normally say who developed it, but that is still unknown. Nobody knows who made this game, and with such limited information on it, theories about what it could actually be, if there was a deeper meaning to it, and who was behind it all, is a mystery. And when something is so void of any type of credible information, speculation tends to take a front seat, as if we can't find answers, people would just make something fit so that closure can be met. But again, why did this game even stand out? And how did it go from a random channel making a Let's Play on it to becoming one of the internet's most infamous stories? It seems that OHC was just as curious, as so many would eventually become, about this game. So the channel's owner, Jamie Farrell, started sharing the video around on Reddit and 4chan, hoping that more people who would see it would know something more about it. Hell, Jamie went on later to state that the only way he ever found out about it was through one of his subscribers who mentioned it to him in a comment. The subscriber in question is still anonymous to this day, but they were interviewed by Kotaku and stated that they found the game when they were on a deep web forum board. This person stated that it was very weird even before starting the game, due to the very nature of the forum board itself, as it wasn't a dedicated video game or horror-based board. More so an all-around type of place that had content ranging from DIY, tech reviews, and fitness. So, the fact that someone randomly posted a user-created game there, of all places, seems to be poor judgment for wanting to share your game with the right crowd. Now, remember what I said, that still to this day, nobody knows the identity of the creator of Sad Satan. So, it may be a strong possibility that whoever posted the game to this forum board was in fact the developer. This random poster went by the handle ZK, and said nothing else other than linking the game to the board. That is the only information that the subscriber was able to give, and this mysterious ZK was seen as the closest thing to the game's developer. But truthfully, whoever ZK was, it wasn't the last time the internet would hear from them.
As more information started to come out about both Sad Satan and the mysterious ZK, it began to form somewhat of a picture, but ultimately just made the mystery surrounding the game even larger. The anonymous subscriber that originally sent the link to Jamie went on to mention that they did not see the posts from ZK around 4chan, and that most of them related heavily to satanic and dark content. But that is as descriptive as the anonymous commenter went. This absence of any solid information caused the infamy of Sad Satan to increase as word was now getting around online due to the Kotaku interview. But like many things, especially when it comes to those with no concrete outcome, theories are bound to fill in the blanks. One of those theories came from the interview that Jamie gave with Otaku. In the interview, Jamie stated that the game contained no instances of gore, violence, or child abuse, stating that the entire rumor based around the game was false. This statement seemed solid for his defense, as in the 5 gameplay videos, none of the previously mentioned things were seen, but this is probably very obvious because if they were in the game, Jamie did show it on his channel, and it would have certainly gotten removed from the platform, if not having his entire channel removed if so. Yet after Jamie's original interview with Kotaku, he would later recant his previous statement and admit that the rumors that the game did include child abuse and gore were accurate, and that he did not include them in the videos for obvious reasons. He also said the reason he lied was due to him not wanting to be responsible for showing that type of material. And honestly, who can really blame him? I get that lying about something like this probably isn't the right thing to do, but when you're an innocent third party, then wanting to keep yourself at a safe distance probably isn't a bad idea. So by now, most of the public who had heard of Sad Satan only knew what existed via Jamie's videos on Obscure Horror Corner, and the alleged content that was shown completely went against the allegations that it included, material that most of us would not want to see. So many were chalking this up to a simple hoax or even a creepypasta, that an online horror game from the deep web showed child abuse. That all obviously changed once Jamie gave the updated interview. But for those who were on 4chan that day, they found out that what Jamie had originally said about that game was a lie, prior to Jamie giving his updated interview. How, you might ask? Well, because someone claiming to be ZK posted the link to what they called the true Sad Satan. This raised a lot of red flags for 2 reasons. One, because when Jamie first shared the link to r/sadsatan, he purposefully gave an invalid link. The reason for this, we can assume, was the same reason he lied about it in the first place. That being, he didn't want to be associated with the disturbing game that had that type of material on it. And the second reason likely being that when ZK uploaded the new link on 4chan, it apparently only worked for some people. And at the time, it was confirmed that it did in fact contain gore and child abuse. But for most who tried downloading the game, it caused numerous problems for their computers, with some people going on to say that their computers had completely stopped working after downloading the game. This quote-unquote true version quickly became dubbed as the quote-unquote clone version. And for many people in the community, the myth surrounding Sad Satan was quickly becoming real. Reddit would step in at this point and take the clone version of the game and remove all of the original graphic material, replacing it with content that, while considered creepy or disturbing, was nowhere near as bad as the quote-unquote clone version. This version, being labeled the clean version, would be the one that most would go on to play and stream on platforms like Twitch and YouTube. This is where the mystery of Sad Satan really gained its notoriety, as by now the legend of it being known as a game that showed things that most would never want to see existed, and that you could find it if you looked hard enough, but the fact that any version that you could find online being played was the clean version only added to the mystery, even though the story and the accusations behind it were seemingly true. But by then, it had become obscured enough online that nobody really knew if it was real or just a hoax to stir up hype for this game. And if the sole purpose of the game was to draw attention to it, it definitely worked. Everyone on the darker side of YouTube, especially the horror gaming community, talked about the game. And with that much attention, it got to the point where people were throwing it up there with movies like The Ring. And that the game itself was cursed, and all those who played it would be too if they didn't share the game around. Thus, building the game's legacy even more.
For many, this wasn't enough. The sheer back and forth on whether or not Sad Satan was really a game as horrific as Formboard said it was becoming overwhelming. So, the internet did what it does best, speculate and investigate. I couldn't find out how exactly this next piece of information was found, but I can assume that people simply started to Google Sad Satan and began their search there. Eventually, what was discovered was something that many around the horror community were completely shocked to learn. And if it did turn out to be true, then it would completely devastate those surrounding the game. The potential answer to ZK's identity came from a video titled Sad Sad Satan, and it was uploaded by a channel named Scarebear. The video itself has nothing to do with the game, and the only thing that connects this YouTube video to the game are the words Sad and Satan. The video contains your typical grotesque shit that many in the horror community on YouTube are used to. Not exactly scary, just more gross and disturbing than anything. I myself have watched it, and I didn't see any kind of profound proof that these two things had anything to do with each other. Truthfully, had the title of this video been anything different, then nobody would connect these two things together. So, for that reason, I am not going to speculate on how this video could relate to Sad Satan. What you can relate to this video, though, is the channel's name, Scarebear, and how it was reported that there was a Reddit account made, and the name of that account was ScareBearZK. For obvious reasons, this stands out. But what makes this even more suspect is the fact that this Reddit account was made 4 days before the clone version of the game was posted to 4chan. And since the clone version was posted by someone claiming to be ZK, we unfortunately can do nothing but assume that these two accounts are run by the same person. So, to recap, we have a 4chan account with the name ZK, a Reddit account named ScareBearZK, and a YouTube channel called Scarebear. We know that the clone version of Sad Satan contains child assault and is clearly directed at violence against children, acts of which I will not be speaking of in this video, as they are too disturbing to talk about. If you want to find out what it consists of, a quick Google search will answer your questions, but be warned, it's something that I would advise against. So, we have got this game, a YouTube channel going by a similar handle, and a video on this channel titled almost identically to the game itself. And We also have one other thing. This second video. This guy. Remember his face, because a lot of people around the internet believe this to be the cryptic ZK. This man's name is Gary Graves, and while he may seem completely random, try to bear with me as I make this connection that seems a little too obvious to ignore. In 2017, a man was arrested in Texas for crimes against children. Again, which I will not be discussing, but you can use your judgment based off of the context of this video. The man that was arrested was also named Gary Graves. Now, put the Gary who was arrested and the Gary from the video side by side, and you can see that they both look incredibly similar to each other. I am not saying that this is 100% without a doubt ZK. But with all of the factors that you can include in this, it certainly seems that it could at the very least be a possibility. If you go to Scarebear's channel and you look at their most recent video, you will see countless comments accusing this Gary to be the same Gary that was arrested. Yet nothing is concrete, at least in my research, that shows that this is for sure the same person. If it is, it's beyond disturbing that a man created a game in which child abuse was featured, to only be arrested years later for similar charges. This is where, for many, the story ends, as there is no updating story surrounding this game. For many, Gary Graves was ZK, and was the one responsible for Sad Satan. A game that was used to show off and express his deep-seated and evil thoughts. If this is true, then it truly shows how disturbing the internet can be. But unfortunately, it cannot be fully proven, as there isn't enough concrete proof. There are similarities, yes, but truthfully, all of it is circumstantial. It could simply be a strange coincidence, or it could be that Sad Satan was the work of a monster who finally made his desires a reality. Perhaps this is why ZK posted the clone version in the first place after Jamie's interview. Maybe ZK was frustrated nobody was taking his game serious and were writing it off as a hoax. Since 2017, after Gary's arrest, no updates have been made on the YouTube channel Scarebear, the Reddit and 4chan accounts have both since been deleted, and even OHC has left YouTube altogether. It seems that all of those associated with this cryptic game just vanished in one way or another. Or who knows, maybe none of these people have anything to do with the actual game, and the real ZK is still out there. I hope you enjoyed this deep dive into the internet's most cryptic video game. I also want to give a huge thank you to Barely Sociable for helping me out with the video. By now, most all of you have heard of him, but in the rare case that you haven't, go check out his channel, because if you enjoy my content, you'll love his. Special thanks to all of my patrons, especially my top tier patrons. Borgov the Straightener, Jace, Maddox B, Beep Beep Bananas, Boop, A Dumb Thought, Alex Hughes, Blake, Flampaya, Jason Fontella, Nelson, OOD Hamhord, Lena, Robert Rep, Ryan93, Sbeeve, and Skelly. I will see all of you in the next video, and remember to stay safe out there, friends. Good night.